Welcome back, everyone. I'm Jordan Giesige, and this is The Limiting Factor. Today, we'll discuss the limiting factor that has prevented Tesla from rolling out vehicle-to-grid technology, what will remove that limiting factor, and which vehicle I expect will be the first to have this feature. In the last video, I promised new information for Battery Investor Day. That video is still coming, and it will be about a half hour long or more. But this video spelled out of the script as a standalone video. First, let's cover off what vehicle-to-grid technology is. Vehicle-to-grid technology just means that you can use your car as battery backup for your house. You could, for instance, store solar power during peak sunshine during the day and use it to power your house at night. Or, if you don't have solar, you could charge the car at night during off-peak rates and use that to power the house during peak rates during the day. And for those who are looking for emergency power backup, you could use your car instead of a generator. It's always frustrated me that we don't have vehicle-to-grid technology widely available, and I've wondered why Tesla hasn't released a vehicle-to-grid package with their home energy products or vehicles. It would make the purchase of a Tesla vehicle a no-brainer. For those with solar or taking advantage of night rates, it would be a cash cow. For those looking for emergency backup power for an entire home, it would save $4,000 or more over a home generator. After stewing in battery research for the past few months, the reason why Tesla hasn't offered vehicle-to-grid is clear to me now. With Tesla's current battery cell chemistry, vehicle-to-grid would greatly reduce the battery life of a Tesla vehicle. Typical daily driving for most people involves shallow discharge and charge cycles. Most people only use around 15% of their battery charge each day. If the battery isn't charged past 80 to 90% overnight, this usage pattern would result in a battery life of about 400,000 miles. 400,000 miles is equivalent to about 2,000 cycles. If the charging and discharging was done more frequently and more deeply, that would quickly drop by 30% or more to around 280,000 miles. And for the edge cases where people are pushing the battery hard, it might be around 50% or more, or 200,000 miles. In either case, it would mean noticeable battery fade after 100,000 miles. This might be okay for the first owner, but the average age of a car on the road is 12 years old and 150,000 miles. It might kill the resale value of a Tesla if the battery is already noticeably fading after 100,000 miles. This would mean a significantly larger number of warranty claims by outliers. Tesla would be left with three choices: take the financial hit, raise prices, or reduce the warranty. Based on this crowdsourced data, there are probably already a significant number of outliers, and double the usage would double the warranty claims or more. This is why we haven't seen vehicle-to-grid from Tesla yet. The battery cycle life just isn't there yet, or wasn't there yet. At Battery Investor Day, I expect Tesla to unveil their million-mile battery, which should do 4,000 cycles and a million miles without a sweat. This is a direct result of research coming out of Jeff Dahn's laboratory at Dalhousie University. If you aren't familiar with Jeff and his connection with Tesla, I've done an in-depth video on Jeff and his lab. I'll link that video above and in the description. This graph is directly from what has been referred to as the Million Mile Battery paper. It's one of the most downloaded publications in the Electrochemical Society's history. This work was led by Jesse Harlow at Dalhousie University and overseen by Jeff Dahn. The team was absolutely flogging the battery, but the battery seemed like it was into it. This was 100% depth of discharge for both tests. At 40 degrees Celsius and 3-hour discharge time, the battery held up well to 4,000 cycles. At room temperature or 20 Celsius and a 1-hour discharge time, the battery lasted 5,000 cycles. Compare that to a normal lithium-ion battery with 100% depth of discharge in black, which is toast after 500 cycles. This battery could be used for daily driving for hundreds of thousands of miles and vehicle-to-grid and still last decades. Will we see a vehicle-to-grid system unveiled at Battery Investor Day with the million-mile battery announcement? Potentially. However, I'd think Tesla would wait until they have a product ready for prime time that could do vehicle-to-grid. It would be best if this vehicle was a utilitarian-type vehicle with a huge battery pack that could power your house for a week. It's clear where I'm going with this. Cybertruck makes sense as the first vehicle for vehicle-to-grid. The Cybertruck already has power outlets, but the vehicle-to-grid would likely come with an app, inverter, and a connector that can handle the power load of an entire house without too much resistance or cable heating. There would be no rush for Model S, X, Y, or 3 until those vehicles are cut over to the new million-mile battery chemistry. Even then, my guess would be that just the Model S and X would have vehicle-to-grid as an option. These vehicles have a larger battery capacity and are in need of an extra feature to goose sales numbers. I'd love to hear your thoughts on this. Let me know in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to like and subscribe. I also have a Patreon, Twitter, and a subreddit. You can find the details of those in the description. A special thanks to Stephen McCandless and Adam Sutton for your generous support of the channel and all the other patrons listed in the credits. I appreciate all of your support, and thanks for tuning in.